Inductively coupled plasma mass spectroscopy was developed in the late 1980s to easily combine the sample introduction and quick analysis of ICP technology with the accurate and low detection limits of a mass spectrometer. The resulting instrument is capable of trace multi-element analysis, often at the part per trillion level. ICP-MS has been widely used over the years, finding applications in a number of different fields, including drinking water, wastewater, natural wastewater systems, hydrology, geology and soil science, mining and metallurgy, food sciences, and medicine. ICP technology was built upon the same principles used in atomic emission spectrometry. Samples are decomposed to neutral elements in a high-temperature argon plasma and analyzed based on their mass to charge ratios. An ICP-MS can be thought of as four main processes, including sample introduction and aerosol generation, ionization by argon plasma source, mass discrimination, and the detection system. The schematic shown illustrates the sequence of processes. On the introduction. Unlike the atomic emission spectrometer, ICP-MS spectrometers can accept solid as well as liquid samples. Solid samples are introduced into the ICP by way of a laser ablation system, which can usually be purchased as an accessory. Aqueous samples are introduced by way of a nebulizer, which aspirates a sample with high-velocity argon, forming a fine mist. The aerosol then passes into a spray chamber where larger droplets are removed via a drain. Typically, only about 2% of the original mist passes through the spray chamber. This process is necessary to introduce droplets small enough to be vaporized in the plasma torch. Once a sample passes through the nebulizer and is partially desolvated, the aerosol moves into a torch body and is mixed with more argon gas. A coupling coil is used to transmit radio frequency to the heated argon gas, producing an argon plasma flame located at the torch. The hot plasma moves into any remaining solvent and causes sample atomization, followed by ionization. In addition to being ionized, sample atoms are excited in the hot plasma, a phenomenon in which the ICP atomic emission spectroscopy is used. Right, on to the interface. Because atomization and ionization occurs at atmospheric pressure, the interface between the ICP and MS components becomes crucial in creating a vacuum environment for the MS system. Ions flow through a small orifice, approximately 1 millimeter in diameter, into a pumped vacuum system. Here a supersonic jet forms and the sample ions are passed into the MS system at high speeds, expanding the vacuum system. The entire mass spectrometer must be kept in a vacuum so that the ions are free to move without collisions with their molecules. Since the ICP is maintained at atmospheric pressure, a pumping system is needed to continuously pull a vacuum inside the spectrometer. In order to most efficiently reduce the pressure, several pumps are typically used to gradually decrease the pressure to 10 to the negative 5th millibar before the ion stream reaches the quadrupole. If only one pump were used, its size would be excessive to reduce the pressure immediately upon entering the mass spectrometer. In the first stage of the mass spectrometer, ions are removed from the plasma by a pumped extraction system. An ion beam is produced and further focused into the actual unit. There are several different types of mass analyzers which can be employed to separate isotopes based on their mass to charge ratio. Quadrupole analyzers are compact and easy to use, but offer lower resolution when dealing with ions of the same mass to charge ratio. Double focusing sector analyzers offer better resolution, but are larger and have higher capital costs. The quadrupole mass filter is made up of four metal rods aligned in a parallel diamond pattern. A combined DC and AC electrical potential is applied to the rods, with opposite rods having a net negative or positive potential. Ions enter into the path between all the rods. When the DC and AC voltages are set to a certain value, only one particular ion is able to continue on the path between the rods, and the others are forced out of this path. This ion will have a specific mass to charge ratio. Many combinations of voltages are chosen, which allow an array of different mass to charge ratio ions to be detected. The most common type of ion detector found in an ICP-MS system is a channeltron electron multiplier. This cone or horn-shaped tube has a high voltage applied to it, opposite in charge of the ions being detected. Ions leaving the quadrupole are attracted to the interior cone surface. When they strike the surface, additional secondary electrons are emitted, which move further into the tube emitting additional secondary electrons. As the process continues, even more electrons are formed, resulting in as many as 100 million electrons at the other end of the tube after one ion strikes the entrance of the cone. One of the great advantages to ICP-MS is extremely low detection limits for a wide variety of elements. Some elements can be measured down to parts per quadrillion range, while most elements can be measured or detected at the part per trillion levels. Thank you.